Welcome to the balmy shores of the Kennet and Avon Canal. Yep, it's that time again. I've been filming the Devizes to Westminster non-stop race for 8 years now, and in all that time, for one reason or another, I've always ended up tracking the main contenders for the overall win. I guess it always seemed like that's where the main story was. But in reality, there are always hundreds of stories out there on the water. Every crew's got a tale to tell. And I guess that's what makes the DW, for me, a compelling and fascinating race. So this year, I decided to do something different. I decided I wasn't going to chase down the whippets in the afternoon. Instead, I was going to travel with the people. But before we tuck into the main course, there's the small matter of the hors d'oeuvres. The Waterside Series, along with its compatriot the Thameside, is seen almost as a compulsory part of the DW experience. For some crews, it's a chance to sharpen the claws ready for battle, especially in the four-day race. For others, it's a thought-provoking glance into the future. But whatever the motives of those using it as a warm-up for the DW, the Watersides are a great race series in their own right. Okay, back to the main event. Crew started leaving Devizes pretty early in the normal fashion, with the tide window at Teddington opening at 6 o'clock the next morning. This year, the wharf was abuzz with excitement, as one crew in particular was getting a lot of attention. Steve Backshall and Helen Glover were taking on the race to raise money to save an endangered rainforest, and the canoeing community had really got behind them. So it's safe to say that Devizes was a little busier than normal as they set off. The standout story in terms of endeavour though were the Royal Marine crews in their heavy folding boats, with some aiming to catch the same tide as the K2s, something they don't normally do. Now the Marines are a major part of DW, always have been, but this year's paddle was part of their 1664 Global Challenge and the commemoration of the 75th anniversary of Operation Frankton. The first focal point for a lot of crews is Pusey Wharf, where they can connect with their support crews for the first time. But to get there, you've got to get past a certain Swan. Cocklebury Farm is one of my favourite early locations. Not just for the action on the water, but also for the surrounding landscape. I wasn't sure whether Sid would be around or not, but I guess I should have known better. To be honest, while I was there, he was a bit hit and miss, which was lucky for some of the crews. And the guy who turned up with bread at one point is now probably a hero to many.
Straight
out with that bow wave at the front.
You just don't
want to
hit
them
with my paddle.
Easy there, fella.
Swing bridges are rather a regular feature and a bit of a lottery on the canal. Some you can get under, some you can't. A few crews engage the services of a bridge man to ride ahead and open them up. Others just have to take it the way they find it.
Right.
Newbury, time for some nosh. Well, no one's really going anywhere at the moment, are they? So might as well fill up. And so night fell, and the Thames beckoned. Some would say this is where the race really begins. And that's where I left them, with just the final run down to Westminster. It was great to stick with the flow of crews heading ever eastwards. It allowed me to film places I'd not been to before, and it also meant I was able to follow the progress of some paddlers all the way from Devizes to well onto the tideway. So there you have it, another one done. Same time next year?